हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडेज टॉपिक ऑफ डिस्कशन इज़ फॉर स्टैंडर्ड फिफ्थ EVS 1, दैट इज़ एनवायरमेंटल स्टडीज़ पार्ट 1, चैप्टर नंबर 2, मोशंस ऑफ द अर्थ. हियर वी विल बी टॉकिंग अबाउट रोटेशन, दैट इज़ अर्थ्स रोटेशन, सनसेट एंड सनराइज, अ ईयर. देयर वी विल बी टॉकिंग अबाउट अ लीप ईयर, एंड द लास्ट टॉपिक विल बी फेजेस ऑफ द मून. सो टू अंडरस्टैंड दिस टॉपिक्स, here we will use some models to understand this. Okay, so let us start by discussing about rotation. Take a top, spin it and observe its movement. The top turns around itself. Any object that turns around itself actually turns around a certain imaginary line. The turning of an object around itself is called rotation, and the imaginary line around which it rotates is called the axis of rotation. Rotation is the movement of the earth on its axis. The earth takes 24 hours to complete one rotation around its axis. Now next, we will talk about the earth's rotation. We will understand the earth's rotation and related things by reviewing a globe. First, we will understand what is plumb line. A cord or thread that has weight attached at one end is called a plumb line. If you cannot get a plumb line, tie a long thread to an eraser and your plumb line is ready. Take a globe and spin it. Note the line around which it rotates. Now take a plumb line and hold it close to the globe as shown in this picture. You will see that the plumb line and the earth's axis as marked over here are at an angle to each other. That is, the earth's axis is inclined. And you can see here the earth's axis is passing through the center of the earth. The N which is marked here is the north pole of the earth, and S which is marked here is the south pole of the earth. The imaginary circle, here you can see a straight line, but it is not a straight line, it's a circle in the middle which is called an equator. So the imaginary circle, which is the equator, divides the earth into two equal parts, that is the northern hemisphere and the southern hemisphere. Okay. Now we will try to understand the sunset and sunrise about a year and also about summer and winter with the help of the model. So let's discuss about the model. Stand a candle in the middle of a large table. Draw a big circle around a candle. Now take a globe and place it at any point of this circle and then light the candle. See that it is dark in the room. Okay. Now, we will assume or suppose the candle as sun, and what we will do, take a red bindi and put it on the globe. Now looking at the globe from the direction of the north pole, that is from the top, turn the globe anticlockwise. This is how the earth rotates, right? That is, it rotates from west to east. Now note, when it is sunrise, noon and sunset at the location of the bindi, after one sunrise, note when the next one occurs at the bindi. You will see that this happens when the earth completes one rotation, that is, when it makes one complete turn around itself. This period of time that the earth takes to complete one rotation is called a day. A day has two parts, daytime and nighttime, which we simply call it as day and night. For the purpose of measuring time, we divide the whole day into 24 parts, each of which is called an hour. Next, a year. The period of time the earth takes to complete one revolution is 365 days. Till now we were talking about rotation. Now we are talking about revolution. Okay. So the period of time the earth takes to complete one revolution around the sun earlier it was at its own axis. Now we are talking about one complete revolution around the sun is called 1 year. There are 365 days and 6 hours in a year. A year is an orbital period of Earth moving in its orbit around the sun. So then, what is a leap year? In the Gregorian calendar, the year is taken as 365 days. It means that it counts 6 hours less every year. So means every year 6 hours is counted less. So 6 hours in the first year, 6 hours in the second year, 6 hours in the third year and 6 hours in the fourth year. So when we add all these hours, we get 24 hours, that is one day. So to make up for this loss of one day, the month of February in the Gregorian calendar has an extra day every fourth year. That year is called as leap year. It has 366 days instead of 365 days, and February has 29 days instead of 28 days. Okay, now you know that the length of the day and night is not always equal. This happens because of Earth's inclined axis and its revolution around the sun. So here we are talking about summer and winter in the northern hemisphere and the southern hemisphere. From 22nd March till 23rd September, between these dates, what happens? It is summer in the northern hemisphere and winter in the southern hemisphere. And what happens between 23rd September till 22nd March? So from 23rd September to 22nd March, it is winter in the northern hemisphere and summer in the southern hemisphere. Okay, in India, summer, the rainy and winter are considered to be the main seasons. We also divide the year into 6 seasons, namely Vasant, Grishma, Varsha, Sharad, Hemant and Shishir. The cycle of 6 seasons is also known as the Rutu Chakra. So with that, we will move to our next topic. That is phases of moon. Doesn't the sky look lovely at night? See the stars shining bright. And look how beautiful moon is. Oh yes, the moon is completely circular today. This called the full moon. I never understand why the moon plays hide and seek with us. I could not find the moon in the sky few nights back. Oh, do you know why that happens? The moon keeps on changing its shape because of its revolution around the earth. The different shapes of the moon are called the phases of the moon. Phases of the moon? Yes, the revolution of the moon around the earth makes the moon appear as if it is changing shape in the sky. From the earth, we see the moon grow from a thin crescent to a full disc and then shrink back to a thin crescent again before vanishing for a few days. The moon shines because it reflects the light from the sun. The part of the moon facing the sun is always lit out and the part facing away from the sun is in darkness. So it is like a torch falling on one side of a ball. Yes, correct. So we see that the lunar phase is the amount of moon we can see from the earth, depending upon how much it is lit up by the sun, and this amount changes every day. The phases of the moon depends on the moon's position in relation to the earth and the sun. As the moon makes its way around the earth, we see the bright part of the moon's surface at different angles. These are called phases of the moon. From full moon to the new moon, the illuminated part of the moon seen from the earth becomes smaller, smaller and smaller. And from new moon to the full moon, it again grows bigger and bigger. These different shapes of the moon that we see are called phases of the moon. Regarding the lunar month and the lunar days, you know that it takes 14 or 15 days from new moon to full moon. This is the fourth night of waxing moon, which is called as Shukla Paksha. After the full moon, the moon appears smaller and smaller. And after 14 to 15 days, it is new moon. This period of the fourth night of the waning moon, which is also called as Krishna Paksha. Thus, the period from one new moon to the next new moon is of 28 days. It is called as lunar month. And every day of the lunar month is called as Tithi. So, this was regarding phases of moon. Always remember that the rotation of the earth gives rise to day and night, and the revolution of the earth around the sun and the inclination of its axis give rise to the circle of the seasons. So this was about chapter number 2, that is the motions of the earth. Hope you understood the lesson. We will again meet in the next video very soon. Till then, goodbye.